If the ratio test works, it works very nicely and really fast, as we will see in the examples in this video. Take for example, this is minus 1 to the power n cubed over 3 to the power n, and we wonder whether this series converges absolutely or not. Let's try to use the ratio test. Our an equals minus 1 to the power n cubed over 3 to the power n, and we can find our n plus 1, plug in n plus 1 on the spot of n, so we get minus 1 to the power n plus 1, and we get an n plus 1 cubed, and here a 3 to the power n plus 1. And before taking any limits, always compute a n plus 1 over a n and simplify a bit. That's often possible, and then take your limit. So we take a n plus 1 over a n plus 1 over a n, and you see a lot simplifies. Minus 1 over minus 1 to the power n plus 1 over minus 1 to the power n just leaves a factor minus 1. We have a 3 to the power n plus 1 and a 3 to the power n, so only one factor 1 over 3 is left. And so those are done, those are done. And we see we are left with the n plus 1 cubed over n cubed. Well, we cannot simplify that further. But we already cleaned up quite a lot of the mess. Then we take the limit n to infinity of this ratio, and then the absolute value. Absolute value of minus 1 over 3 equals 1 over 3, and we can take that out because it is not influenced by the limit. Limit n to infinity, n plus 1 over n cubed. You can do a number of things. Easiest is to turn it into 1 plus 1 over n cubed. Of a continuous function, you can take in the limit. So you get limit n to infinity of 1 plus 1 over n cubed equals 1 cubed equals 1. So you get 1 over 3 as your final answer. So your L equals 1 over 3, which is smaller than 1, which means that your original series is absolutely convergent due to the ratio test. So you see, in order to apply the ratio test, you compute a n plus 1, compute the ratio, simplify a bit, take one limit, and then you know whether your series is convergent or not. Let's try to do one which looks really ugly. N to the power n over n factorial. So your a n equals n to the power n over n factorial. What about your a n plus 1? So plug in on all spots n plus 1 for n. So you get the n plus 1 to the power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 factorial. But you can simplify n plus 1 factorial a bit. Because like, well, 5 factorial equals 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So that equals 5 times 4 times 3 times 2. So 5 factorial equals 5 times 4 factorial. And in the same way, n plus 1 factorial equals n plus 1 times n factorial. It's a trick we'll often use. So that's for the denominator. Then we look at the numerator. There we have n plus 1 to the power n plus 1. So that is n plus 1 times n plus 1 times n plus 1 times n plus 1, and that n plus 1 times. Or n plus 1 times n plus 1 to the power n. So we can factor out one factor n plus 1. And why do we do that? Well, of course, because those cancel out then. So our a n plus 1 equals n plus 1 to the power n divided by n factorial. And then if you take the quotient a n plus 1 over a n, absolute value doesn't matter because all terms are positive. Then we see that the n plus n factorials nicely cancel out, and we're left with n plus 1 to the power n divided by n to the power n, and we can write that as 1 nth power. Then we take the limit n to infinity, n plus 1 over n equals 1 plus 1 over n to the power n, and this limit is a standard limit, it's the number of Euler. You can either view it as the definition of the Euler number, or you can use the limit trick and write this e to the power ln, this factor, and find the limit. It's e, which is bigger than 1. So according to the ratio test, our original series is divergent. So that's the second example. You see here we had to work slightly harder, because our an was really, really ugly. But still, ratio test worked nicely. Let's go to the last example, my nemesis. As you may remember from the first calculus exam, I did this ratio test there back then as well, the 1 over n ln n. Well, let's just try to do it. The ratio test works so nicely. So we compute a n plus 1 over a n. So we get 1 over n plus 1 times ln n plus 1 and here 1 over n times ln of n. We can simplify a bit over here. And then take the limit n to infinity. We can split up the limit in two parts because they both exist. E equals 1 times 1 equals 1. So here you see limit equals 1. So ratio test does not give an answer. So that can happen. And in that case, you will have to do other tests. If the ratio test works, it works really nicely. It works often, but sometimes it gives one, and then you have to come up with something else.